Thank you so much, Dean, and it's a real honor for me to join you all here today, the health leaders of the future. And let me just tell you, we need you. So it's wonderful to have a chance to be here as you launch the next phases of your career. I am the Secretary of Health and Human Services, but I think about this school each and every day. And I do that because I'm surrounded by talented alums from the Mailman School of Public Health. I work every day with some of your distinguished colleagues. My director of the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, Tom Frieden, is a graduate of this school. Our new wonderful commissioner at the Food and Drug Administration, Peggy Hamburg, is a graduate of this school. And earlier this year, we were fortunate enough to lure Sherry Gleed, who is sitting in the front row, to Washington. Yes, and you all know Sherry. Yes. Sherry is our long overdue Assistant Secretary of Planning and Evaluation, and her job is to advise me in all areas of health and human services policy. So I had to make a deal when I accepted this invitation to come to you today. My deal with Dr. Fried is I wouldn't take any more graduates with me when I left, at least not tonight. But I don't think there's any doubt this is a very special school, and the Executive Master's Program is a very special program. You have already established yourselves in your careers, whether it's caring for patients, managing a clinic, developing new medicines, or in another aspect of a health profession. And no one forced you to do this, to give up 4 days a month for 2 years, to get used to doing homework again, or study accounting. Who knew? But many of you came to this program because you weren't satisfied with the personal success you had already achieved. You wanted to make a bigger difference. You wanted to use your skills and experience to help more people, change more lives. And it took an unusual level of dedication on your part. If you're going to dedicate your career to improving health and healthcare in America, going to dedicate it to public health, as I hope you will, I have to warn you now, there's a lot of work to do. By now, you understand as well as anyone the challenges that we face. And let me just give you a brief snapshot of sort of where we are. We have more than 50 million people in our country who have no health insurance at all, the highest number since people have begun recording those numbers. Many of those families are just a car accident away from going bankrupt. The share of children in our country who were overweight has quadrupled in the last 40 years. And while America leads the world in medical research, medical care, and healthcare spending, we don't even come close to leading the world in health results. By some measures, like how long we live, we're not even in the top 25 countries. We're behind countries like Bosnia and Jordan. Because our health system is so vast, it's easy to feel overwhelmed by these inefficiencies and shortcomings. Trying to improve the safety and quality of our system can feel like climbing a very tall mountain. It's hard to tell if you're making any progress. The summit never seems to get much closer. And the temptation to give up and go do something a lot easier can be pretty strong. But the fact that you all are here today, graduating from this program, tells me that you're optimists. And that's good, because I have some positive news for you this afternoon. There's never been more opportunity to improve our healthcare system than there is today. Now, I'm not just talking about the recent legislation, although that is pretty historic. It's true that during this administration, some big steps have been taken toward improving health, from passage of the Affordable Care Act, probably the single most important piece of health legislation, at least since Medicare, maybe ever in this country, giving Americans access to affordable health insurance, but also a platform in the Recovery Act, which made historic investments in prevention and wellness in community projects around the country, investments in electronic health records to finally move us from a paper and pen system in the health system into the electronic era, in our healthcare workforce, where we need more providers in more underserved communities, and the First Lady's Let's Move campaign, bringing together partners across the country to help families make healthier choices. So you're leaving Columbia with your new degree at a time of enormous potential. We have better models than ever before for how to deliver high-quality healthcare at a reasonable price. And the challenge for you will be how to make these promising models and innovative approaches spread throughout the country.